We're going to look at the same sort of things that we did with a first order rate law for zero order and second order rate laws. The kinetics. So again, our general reaction is some reactant is going to products, and the rate is going to be equal to the negative change in concentration of that reactant over the change in time. Now, if the rate law is equal to K concentration of the reactant to the zeroth power, anything to the zero is one, right? This is just equal to K. That's a zero order reaction. If it's a zero order reaction, then these are the important equations for you to remember. The integrated rate law will be the concentration of the reactant at any time T is equal to negative the rate constant K times T plus the concentration of the reactant initially. Notice this is the equation of a straight line, Y equals MX plus B, where the slope is negative K. And so if we were to plot the concentration of the reactant versus time, if it's a zero order reaction, we should get a straight line. The half-life is equal to the initial concentration of the reactant divided by 2 times the rate constant. That's 2K. Memorize these, know when to use them. So zeroth order, if we plot concentration of A versus T, we should get a straight line, the slope being negative the rate constant. If it's a second order reaction, that means the rate is equal to negative change in concentration of A over change in time is going to be equal to K times the concentration of the reactant squared. The integrated rate law looks like this, 1 over the concentration of the reactant equals KT, notice no negative this time, plus 1 over the initial concentration of the reactant. And the half-life is equal to 1 over K times the initial concentration of A. Memorize both of these. And notice this is a straight line, the equation of a straight line, Y equals MX plus B, where Y is 1 over the concentration of the reactant, the slope is the rate constant, and the y-intercept is 1 over the initial concentration, 1 over. So memorize these guys. So for example, for a second order reaction, the combination reaction of this molecule, if we were to plot the concentration versus time, it's certainly not linear. But if we were to plot 1 over the concentration versus time, we get a linear graph. Notice that it's a positive slope as opposed to a negative slope like we've seen before. And there's the integrated rate law. So now we can use this. Okay, we have this chemical reaction, decomposition of nitrogen dioxide into nitrogen monoxide and oxygen. And we want to find three things: the order of the reaction, the rate constant, and the half-life, and we're given this set of data. The concentration of nitrogen dioxide is a function of time, initially, and so on. So the way to do this, okay, is first we want to find the order. Once we know the order, we know the integrated rate law and the form of the half-life equation. So what we're going to do is plot this data, and we're going to plot the concentration versus time, natural over the concentration versus time, and 1 over the concentration versus time. That would be in order zero order, first order, or second order, depending upon which gives us the best straight line. So I've done that for you. This is the concentration versus time. This is obviously not a straight line. The data do not line up on. This is a straight line. So if this were a straight line, if this data were a straight line, we would know it's zero order, but it's not. This is the natural log of the concentration of nitrogen dioxide versus time. It's a little bit closer, but still, it's not as good as this, which is the 1 over the concentration of nitrogen dioxide versus time. This graph gives us the best straight line, so we say this is a second order reaction. Okay, now that we know it's second order, okay, and by the way, I had the spreadsheet give us the equation of the best fit straight line. The slope is gonna be our K. Remember, it's not negative K because it's second order, and that's our y-intercept. So slope's about 0.709. Per mole or per second. So, answering the question, it's second order, and we know the slope from the equation of the line. Or, alternatively, if we didn't have that equation, all we have to do is use the integrated rate law and solve it for K. I've done the algebra, check my algebra, please. And plug in, okay, the initial concentration of nitrogen dioxide and some concentration at whatever time it corresponds to. So pick a point in the data table. I picked the next to the last one. So I plugged in this. You could have picked any, you know, any other one. This is the initial concentration. This is the, at 11.4 seconds, the concentration was 0.0497. Plugging in, solving this, you get the same thing as we did from the slope of the line. So now that we know K, we know it's second order, we can find the half-life just plugging into the equation for the half-life of a second order reaction. It's 1 over K concentrate, the initial concentration. Plugging in, we get half-life's about 17 seconds.